Just see if we have covered all the points or not. If any point is not covered, then you can tell me that, okay, this thing was not covered today. These things what we did is not covered in the recording. तो कोई पॉइंट अगर रिकॉर्डिंग में छूट गया है या कहीं पे आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही है या स्क्रीन नहीं दिख रहा है क्लियरली, उस टाइम पे यू कैन टेल मी. सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद ऑक्सीजन एनालाइजर. ऑक्सीजन इन एटमॉस्फेयर वी हैव अराउंड 21% ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑन शिप्स व्हेन वी आर कैरिंग लॉट ऑफ कार्गोज विच हैव टॉक्सिक गैसेस, हाइड्रोकार्बन गैसेस and deficient, there are so many enclosed spaces or places, tanks and holds which are deficient of oxygen. And for human existence and survival in the atmosphere, we need 21% oxygen generally is available, and minimum 19.5% we need oxygen for proper functioning of the human body. So oxygen is a very critical thing, and also the other operations when we are doing to avoid flammable range like inerting and all, we need less than 5% oxygen. So all, so many places are there and so many operations are there where we need to monitor the oxygen, and that's why we need this oxygen analyzers. So mostly we have portable oxygen analyzers like this, and there are different types of oxygen analyzers. We have zirconia based paramagnetic and electrochemical cell. So first let's see the electrochemical based oxygen analyzer. In electrochemical based oxygen analyzer, just normal galvanic cell which we have studied, there is one anode, there is one cathode, there is an electrolyte, and the electric current is flowing. Now what we have in this sensor extra is we have a semi-permeable membrane which requires from which the oxygen will be diffused into this system, and because of its properties or circulation this in this electromagnetic cell, whatever that normally this because of the flow of electric current in this galvanic cell there is a meter reading, and because of the presence of oxygen whatever is the change in the reading will be measured in this indicator, and that will be our oxygen percentage or reading, which will be from this indicator the reading will be calculated or measured or modulated, and on the this meter screen we can see the reading of the oxygen. So that is our electromagnetic oxygen electrochemical cell principle of oxygen meter. So the questions in this can be that why we have a permeable membrane, because the electrodes, if there is lot of gas, unnecessary gas present, we need to have only minimum amount of gas present so that electrodes are, this electrochemical cell is not working again and again, and electrodes are not getting used up. And also we have the membrane which allows only oxygen to pass and other gases are not present. So it is a sensitive instrument and sensitive membrane. If any acid or any other chemical or water or gases pass, then instruments can be damaged. So disadvantage of this system is this sensitivity or can get damaged, and also electrodes can get burned up or used up. But advantage, it is cheap, very simple and easy to make and good. Then we have the electrodes used are zinc and gold. Gold is very inert and does not react with any other material, and not that much expensive when we are considering the value of life. And in reactivity series, zinc is very close to gold, and it also does not get reacts with other materials. And the electrolyte used is your potassium chloride, or you can use sodium chloride also. So this is all about your electrochemical oxygen analyzer. The next thing is about your zirconium operated oxygen analyzer. So in this, we have a platinum element. We have a platinum element inside, and a second layer of platinum element is outside, and in which we have a zirconium ceramic material, which why we are using this zirconia is mixed with while making the ceramic material, because it is very, it does not corrode and it's very hard material, and it can be affected at high temperature with the oxygen ions and can produce EMF. So what is happening? We have a steel shell outside with perforated holes. So oxygen from the wherever measuring place in enclosed space or tank can enter inside. So here the diagram is showing from the engine room when we are measuring for the fuel oil ratio in the injectors, but anywhere we can use this. So zirconium is a very highly sensitive and accurate material and very expensive also. So the gas which we want to measure, like here from the exhaust, is entering here, the oxygen, with oxygen, the oxygen which is going, it will create an EMF and the ions will be generated, and the generated EMF will be there. Same time, the fresh air from the outside is also made to enter in this cell. And there is a heater here. The heater will heat the gas to a very high temperature. Why we want to heat the air? Because the property of oxygen at a certain temperature will only make the ions to move and create an EMF when it gets in touch with these materials like platinum and zirconium. So once the EMF is generated from the outside air, and there is a EMF and ions, free ions generated from your the air which is entering from the measurement exhaust or something. So if this EMF or oxygen is more, then the difference will, there will be a lot of difference, and that difference will be measured in your voltmeter. If difference is less, that less difference will be measured in your voltmeter. And all these things will go in your measurement cell. And then you can measure the oxygen readings. So this is about your zirconium cell. So this is a zirconia oxygen sensor, which you see is a very sensitive equipment. See this one, the generally electrochemical or paramagnetic, is so simple looking, like portable. And this is used in laboratories or well, very high accuracy or something is required. Then the last part is your paramagnetic sensor. So first let us see what is paramagnetic. We have three types of materials: paramagnetic, diamagnetic and ferromagnetic. So materials which when passed through a magnetic field, their electrons or electric field, when they are repelled or they move away from the magnetic field, the forces, that they are called diamagnetic. But they are very slightly repelled. So when there is a slight repulsion of magnetic field from the material, that material will be diamagnetic. Like here you can see the lines of magnetic waves are moving away. Then paramagnetic materials which attract the magnetic field slightly, like aluminium or oxygen, which we are talking about. So oxygen is paramagnetic, which means when a magnetic field is passing from it, it will be attracted towards the oxygen, some part of the magnetic field. And ferromagnetic means there is a full crowd or cluster of magnetic field which is attracted towards the material. So oxygen is paramagnetic, means it is attracted towards your magnetic field. So now let's understand this paramagnetic oxygen sensor, which is highly sensitive and which was used before, not much used in the portable sensor. So we have two glass spheres which are filled with nitrogen. So why glass spheres? Because this cell is using this mirror with the light reflection and photo detection principle that we will see. So that's why we need the glass spheres to reflect the light and put on this mirror. then these glass spheres are filled with nitrogen. Why nitrogen? Because nitrogen is inert. We don't want air or any other gases to be filled, because they can react and then differ with the oxygen measurement if they are leaking or something. So this filled with nitrogen, which is inert. Now these are, you have two magnetic poles which are creating the magnetic field, and with the presence of magnetic field, these glass spheres can rotate when the oxygen comes. So because they should rotate, they are suspended freely, and then you have a photo detector cell, and there is a reflecting mirror. So there is a some like you have in mobile lights or something. So there is a light or an infrared ray source. This infrared ray source is there inside this oxygen sensor compartment. And when the oxygen enters, it has a paramagnetic properties. Magnetic field is already there because of the magnet. And when the oxygen comes, this paramagnetic field is disturbed, and which causes this glass spheres to rotate. When the glass spheres are rotating, they reflect this light or infrared thing on the mirror, and the mirror amplifies the signal and sends it to the photo detectors. And with the photo detectors, this signal is passed again to the measurement cell. Now the measurement cell is working on a null measurement principle, that whatever the torque is generated, it will generate an anti-torque to nullify the effect of that torque. And whatever torque it is, anti-torque it is generating, that will be measured and displayed on the, after computing on the main screen, how much oxygen percentage is there. So that is about our paramagnetic sensor. So it has two nitrogen gases filled, two glass spheres filled with nitrogen and rotating freely, and oxygen is passing and attracted in the magnetic field, and the strength of the torque is measured. So this is one more diagram of with magnetic fields and magnetic poles, the glass spheres, and oxygen is passing, and it is light is scattered and which is measured. Next thing is calibration. So let's see what is calibration. Calibration means that checking that the instrument is giving correct reading. So as you can see, this instrument, this is a portable oxygen analyzer. In air we have 21% oxygen. So this instrument, when we are starting in air, it is giving 20.9% or 21% oxygen, and that is your what you call calibration of air. So you put in, start in the air, and it is showing correct 21% oxygen. That means that this instrument is calibrated with air and it's working properly. Then the next thing is that why do we also do the calibration with span gas. Span gas means a gas which has a predetermined concentration of oxygen. Like here we have 31.95. So if it is a 31.95% oxygen in this, when you connect this span gas or calibration gas to your instrument, that should also show your same amount of oxygen. If it is showing same amount of oxygen, that means it's working properly and it is calibrated. So we have different calibration. We have ship's calibration and shore calibration. Like this, we can do on the ship. Depending on the company, we do 3 monthly or 6 monthly. And then we also have shore calibration, which is done annually. Then next thing, when we start the instrument, it will show warming up time, and then there will be a circuit test or lamp test. Then the battery will show. We have to check the battery is charged or not. And there are two types of calibration test. One is auto calibration, which is also called the bump test. Auto calibration means you have already put in the concentration of the gas, and once this gas is coming, if the concentration is up and down, then it will change the reading automatically and make it to 32. And manual calibration, you have to adjust the reading. Suppose this is 35 and you bring it down to 32, that is manual calibration. If it is automatically adjusting to 32, it is bump test. So we check the battery, bump test, circuit. Then there is an alarm. Alarm setting is given for suppose oxygen is less than 19. So we need an alarm. So that we can check the oxygen, which is the air which is coming out of the mouth is around 16% oxygen. So when we blow this air from the mouth into this system, the reading will go down less than 18 or 19%. And whatever is your alarm setting, the alarm will activate and we can check that the alarm is working. In case of problem in the tank, that alarm will activate. And there is also a zero calibration. If when the instrument is starting before operation, if it is not showing zero reading, that there is a zero adjustment how to do, it will be given in your instruction manual and we can do the zero adjustment. So for the summary, we have three types of equipment: zirconia, electromagnetic, and paramagnetic. Mostly for small instruments, electromagnetic or sometimes paramagnetic is used. Zirconia is for others' accuracy. We have calibration, zero adjustment, alarm, battery check, and that is all the maintenance of your oxygen analyzer. So is there anything which is missed out?
No, sir.
Everything is covered?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any doubts? Anybody has?
No, sir.
So we can stop for today.